Let's turn our Bibles, if we can, to Luke 21, verse 25. Luke 21, verse 25. Luke 21, verse 25. Kaylee and Zach, at the end of service, be prepared for your short testimony. And there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars, and on the earth, distress of nations with perplexity, the sea and the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them. Now, let me say something about that, because when they spoke that in the Hebrew, when he said men's there, he's talking about mankind, all humans. So that we're clear, he's talking about all humans right there, mankind. So let me go back. Men's hearts failing them from fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on earth, for the power of heaven will be shaken. Watch this. Watch this. Then they will see. Oh, Lord. They will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. So good right there. Look at somebody and just tell them, I will fear no evil. Now watch this. Wait a minute. I know you just told people that really know you, and they probably know your fear level. Look at somebody you don't know and tell them, I will fear no evil. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's it. We have become a nation paralyzed by fear. We have allowed the enemy to divide us with the spirit of fear. The Bible says that the enemy goes about as a roaring lion, seeking who he may devour. The purpose of the roar of the lion is to paralyze and terrorize, to leave you helpless with fear. Now, when I read that scripture, Veronica, and it says the enemy is seeking whom he can devour, it makes me know there are some people he can't devour. Are we going to teach today? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The difference between those who can and cannot be devoured is predicated on how you react to the roaring. When life roars at you and you forget who you are and whose you are, and you forget what God gave you, and you forget where God has brought you from, you become a candidate for the spirit of fear. But if you can remember whose you are, I am a child of the Most High God. If you can remember whose you are, my Bible says, I'm sealed with a guarantee. It says the Holy Ghost has sealed me with a guarantee that I belong to Jesus. Whew. Hallelujah. Whew. When you begin to know who you are, and you begin to know whose you are, you can begin to neutralize the spirit of fear. But let's be real this morning, okay? Because I'm a real preacher. You know that, Carrie. I don't care how holy you are. how much faith you say you got, saved 55 years with a cross on your car, there are going to be some things that shake you up. There are going to be some things that shake us up. All right? But the difference is, those of us who know Jesus, when we shook up, we know the difference from concerned and petrified. We know the difference from careful and intimidated. We know the difference from cautious and paranoid. I'm trying to help us today. The enemy loves for you to be afraid because he knows when you're afraid, you don't think right. When you're afraid, you don't talk right. When you're afraid, you don't act right. When you're afraid, you don't do nothing right because you're responding out of emotions, not the Holy Ghost. I'm trying to help us. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost on me heavy, Miss Hanson. You're going to have to pray for me right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whew. Satan came here to terrorize whoever he could. If we are really going to declare war on the enemy, we must understand that spirit, that fear is a spirit. If we're truly going to declare war on the enemy, we have to truly understand that fear is a spirit. We got to get started by fighting, getting back on our knees, pleading the blood, rebuking the devil, casting out every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God. Let me show you something. Let's look at the Bible. Because if it ain't Bible, I said if it ain't Bible, let's look at Ephesians chapter 6:12. Go to the Bible. Ephesians chapter 6:12. The Bible says, "For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of darkness of this age." This age. Right now, Maribel. This ain't no history lesson. This is a right now word. When I teach the Bible, Maribel, he's talking to them, but speaking to me and you. Listen, against the rulers of darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts. All right, all right. Now, let's go to 2 Corinthians 10:4. The Bible says, now here's our weapons. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds, casting down arguments, casting down arguments in every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity. I'm sick and tired of my team, my church, my team, my church, walking around like we wimp dogs and we in trouble. We the power. What are you talking about, preacher? There's stuff gonna hit our lives. Cancer comes in. Cancer's right here, but if cancer is above, my God is a healer. If cancer is above, my God will supply all of my needs through his riches and glory. If cancer is above, by his stripes I'm healed. You got to get up there and cast that down. Get down, you too high. If depression is high, I'm not saying it won't hit, but if depression is higher than your Bible that says my God didn't give me a spirit of fear. He gave me a spirit of joy and courage and a sound mind. If it's higher than that word, you got to grab it and pull it down. Yes, Lord. Yes, sir, Father, I tell him. The devil is a terrorist. He doesn't want your house. He don't want our money around. He don't need no money. What do he buy? He steal everything. The devil don't want your wife. He don't want to be married. The devil wants our faith. He wants us in fear. The devil wants us in fear. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We got to choose this day. We got to make a choice this day. Are we going to operate with the devil thriving on fear? Or are we going to operate with God growing in faith? Today, we got to choose. We've got to choose this day. Who are we going to ride with? The devil thrives on fear, but God moves by faith. Watch this. Watch this. The enemy wants to plant fear in your ear. The enemy wants to plant fear in your ear. He's whispering, saying, that's going to kill you. You dead. You in trouble. You too old. You ain't never coming out of this. That's a horrible situation. It's unfixable. Your kids ain't gonna never come off drugs. You know, in the hood, we used to say this, and it was dumb. It is what it is. No, we should have said it is what Jesus says it is. Ain't no is what it is. Ain't no is what it is no more, y'all. It is what Jesus says it is. Watch this. I feel the Holy Ghost in here so heavy. Man, I feel the Holy Ghost. You're going to have to pray for me. I don't know if I can get this out, my Jewish buddy. Watch this. What's worse than the event is the terror or the threat that the enemy has created, the spirit of fear. Let me be real. Let me bring it down here because y'all know I like to bring it. And y'all can leave me by myself, that's okay. I'm willing to testify and be used by the Lord. I've already committed to that. You ever been in a situation, Remy, where you knew you messed up? Chris, you knew you was in trouble. And they said, you're in trouble. We'll talk to you in 2 days. So for 2 days, I'm like, what? It's going to happen. What's going on? I'm running this in my head and this in my head, and I'm dead and I'm guilty and I'm sentenced and I'm gone and I'm punished. And the enemy wants to get in your ear and create terror and threat that's greater than the event. Ooh. Hallelujah. Oh, I feel the Holy Ghost in this place. How many of you know that Jesus describes us as sheep? Where are my cowboys at? Oh, there they go. How many of you know the enemy declares us as sheep? Now, Ramey, I gotta be real. I had a little problem with that because I know what sheep are like. You know, I'm like, God, why are you gonna make me the animal that's fat? You're going to make me the animal that don't comb his hair. You're going to make me the animal that's defensible. Why couldn't you, God, make me the gazelle so I could run? Or make me the silverback gorilla so I could fight? God said, you the sheep. Ooh. He made me the sheep because we are vulnerable. And God said, not only that, he said, you the sheep and you vulnerable. But then God said, but I sent you out amongst wolves. So wait a minute, God. You done made me a sheep and you sending me out amongst wolves. And then God had the nerve to say, you a sheep, get out there with the wolves and don't have a spirit of fear. You better have a spirit of joy and courage and a sound mind. Oh, my goodness. How am I going to do that, God? Why, God? He said, because the weapons of your warfare are mighty in the spirit, pulling down strongholds in Jesus' name. How many of you know the good news about being a sheep is Jesus is our good shepherd? How many of you know the good news about being a sheep is Jesus is our shepherd? Tell your neighbor, just tell your neighbor again, I will not fear any evil. You know, every so often we will encounter, Nate, every so often we're going to encounter a lion, and we're going to encounter a wolf or a snake, Nate. Every so often it might show up on our job, and every so often it show up in our neighborhood. And quite frankly, you can bank on this one. You can bank on this one that the snake, that the wolf, that the lion will show up in church. In our church. I'll just be clear with you. Let's just be real. But that's okay. That's what we want. Because much is given, much is required. We got a barnyard church. This is an ICU unit. I want every one of the snakes, the wolves, the devils to come in here and get this Jesus. Because God says, if you'll take on a bigger assignment, I'll pull out a bigger anointing. Much is given, much is required. When you get sick and you go to your primary care doctor, Jack, he make a certain amount of money. But when they send you to the specialist, he get paid a lot of money. So we specialists, we get the tough assignments. Amen? Glory be to God. Hallelujah. 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 I want to bring your attention to Psalms 23. I want to bring your attention to Psalms 23 because it is the lethal weapon in the hands of the believing sheep. Psalms 23. Because Psalms 23 is the lethal weapon in the hands of a believer. Maribel, stop fighting with your hands and grab Psalms 23. I'm going to show you what to do. Glory be to God. It starts off in Psalms 23. Telling me who Jesus is. And if I can determine who Jesus is, then I can be confident in who I am. Because here's the thing. If you don't know who you are and you don't know who Jesus is, you will begin to glorify the enemy and his attacks. You will begin to start talking to people about how big your debt is. How sick you are, how much trouble you in. It can get so bad while you walking not knowing who you are, walking not knowing who God is, that you will begin even in your prayer life to start talking to God about the devil and nothing about God. God, I got this problem. God, he did this. And God, he did that. And God's sitting up there talking about, you keep talking to me about that chump. Keep talking to me about me. I got victory in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Because if we don't start understanding who we are, the devil will start getting the glory. Let's look at Psalms 23:1. Let's start walking through Psalms 23 so we can understand the lethal weapon that we have as sheep. Psalms 23:1 says, the Bible says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Watch this. Watch this, Butch. He said, Jesus is. Not gonna be. Not should be. Not maybe. Jesus is my shepherd. He's mine on my job. He's mine on the airplane. He's mine in my trouble. Now understand that I'm his. I'm his. I belong to him. But here's where grace really begins. He belongs to me. Glory be to God. He is my personal shepherd. He's my personal shepherd. That's why Pastor Michael don't care about no clique. I don't care about no special society. I don't care about no denomination. Because if I was the only person on earth, Jesus would still come to the cross for me. He's my personal shepherd. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why Nate, when David went up against Goliath, he said, wait a minute, giant. or wait a minute, lone. or wait a minute, sickness. Or wait a minute, trouble. Or wait a minute, despair. Or wait a minute, giant. Do you know that the Lord is my shepherd? Do you know that the Lord is my shepherd? You know when you describe something that belongs to you and you use the pronoun my as an adjective, right? You say my car. You say my house. You say my wife. You're using a pronoun and as an adjective to describe what belongs to you. What the Bible says, my Jesus, the Lord is my shepherd. He belongs to me. Now, I know that messes with somebody's religion up in here today because it seems like I'm making Jesus small. I'm not making Jesus small. I'm making Jesus personal. Glory to God. The Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. Devil, you can't terrorize me with lack because my Jesus has supplied all of my needs. I didn't say will. I said has supplied all of my needs through his riches and glory. My Bible says every spiritual blessing that I need is already sitting there waiting on me with Jesus. Wait a minute. You're not waiting on God. God is waiting on you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Devil, you can't terrorize me with lack. If I'm hungry, Jesus is my bread. If I'm thirsty, Jesus is water. If I'm scared, Jesus is protection. If I'm lonely, Jesus is good company. You can't put my Jesus in a box, for he is the I am, the I am. Glory be to God. Now, scripture goes on to tell us what Jesus did. It starts off in Psalms 23, just giving us a declaration of who Jesus is and who we are, that Jesus is my shepherd, and I shall not want. But then scripture goes on to tell who Jesus is. I'm talking about the big he, the big H-E. Let's look at what the big H-E does. Let's look at Psalms 23, verse 2 through 3. The Bible says he makes me lie down in green pastures. He, Jesus, leads me, let me say it again, leads me beside still waters. He, my Jesus, restores my soul. He, my Jesus, leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. The Bible says he made me lie down in green pastures. Have you ever had God just put you in a green pasture? Have you ever had God just bless you and you couldn't even explain what happened? Oh, my God. Come on, somebody. God will just lay you down in a blessing that you couldn't earn it. You didn't deserve it. You don't even know how it happened. God just laid you down in a green pasture. I had a man call me on the phone one day. He said, Pastor, can you help me? I said, what is it? He said, somebody paid my bill at the restaurant. And I don't know who it is. Do you know? I said, God don't want you to know. Why? Because it's God who laid him down in a green pasture. Whew. Oh, glory be to God. Thank you, Lord. You made me lay down in the green pasture when I didn't have the sense to know what was good for me. When I was nervous, he made me lay down in a green pasture. When I felt vulnerable, he made me lay down in a green pasture. But then it's interesting because Jesus says then he leads me to still waters. He leads me to still waters. Now, I'm glad Jesus didn't say, woman of God, that I pushed him to still waters. Because if Jesus would have pushed me to still waters, then that means I'd be in front. But when Jesus said he leads me to still waters, that means Jesus is in front. Now, let's talk about that for a minute. Let me extrapolate some kingdom principle revelation to you. When Jesus says, hey, I'm leading you to still waters, you got to understand something. The sheep have an instinct to go drink in the water. But they also are not sensitive to their environment. So the sheep would normally, they'll just run up to a lake that has violent current, that the waves are crazy, the water is crazy, because it only has an instinct to drink but not a sensitivity of the environment. And the sheep can mess around and go to a river that's violent or a river that's strong, fall in and could drown. But Jesus said, I'm going to lead you to still waters. What is Jesus saying? Jesus said, I ain't going to give you a woman you can't handle. I ain't going to give you kids you can't handle. I'm not going to give you an assignment you can't handle. I didn't give you a job you couldn't handle because I led you to still waters. Oh, I don't know about you, but I thank the Lord that he didn't give me anything I couldn't handle. You see, he leads me to still waters. Now, the big he said, he restores my soul. He restores my soul. So even if the enemy roars, even if I forget, even if I fall, even if I did doubt, even if I'm wounded, even if I lost my joy, even if I missed the prayer meeting, even if I missed the mark, I gotta still praise Jesus, because Jesus keeps restoring my soul. Jesus keeps restoring my soul. I don't know, is there anybody in here that can remember Jesus restored you? Give God some praise on that right now. Jesus restored me. Whew. Every time the devil thought he had me, God reached in and grabbed me. Sheila, I almost quit. I almost flipped out. You think you did? I almost cussed him out. But Jesus restored me. Oh, y'all don't want to be real in here, but I will. Jesus restored me. Whew. Oh, my God. I will fear no evil. I will fear no evil. Now, I like this because he said, the big he leads me into righteousness. Whatever path you on, if you grab hold to Jesus, he'll lead you to righteousness. That's why he sent the Holy Spirit pushing us back in the right path. Now, I know y'all probably going to leave me by myself on this one, But God has given me the assignment to be a sacrificial lamb, and that's what I am. So I'll testify. I'll work 8 days. I'll do whatever needs to be done that the kingdom of God grows in this time. I want to talk to you about being led to righteousness by the Holy Ghost. Not some legalistic person shouting in my face. I'm talking about by the Holy Ghost. I backslid before. And I know you don't want to hear that. Oh, Pastor? Ah, but when I backslid, Jesus pushed me back into the path of righteousness. You see, when I found myself sliding, I grabbed hold to Jesus' garment. And when I grabbed hold to Jesus' garment, he pulled me back in the right path and started pulling me down the road. You see, I don't know about you, but my righteousness didn't come on my own. I couldn't get righteous on my own. I needed Jesus. I need Jesus now. If I'm going to be righteous, I need Jesus. I need the Holy Ghost pulling on me and tugging on me and convicting me and talking to me and loving me and hugging me and guiding me. Oh, my God, I need the Holy Ghost. Whew. Hallelujah. 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 Let's look at Psalms 23:4. Watch this. Watch this. Now he says, after he's told us that I'm going to lead you, after he told us I'm going to take you to still waters, after he told us I'm going to take you to green pastures. Now, watch this. Now he says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Okay. Watch this. Watch this. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Now, here's Jesus. And he's speaking to our challenges. Because even Jesus, he being the big he, knows that we the little me, and we're going to be susceptible to some challenges. Come on, somebody. Jesus says, there will be some valleys. He says, but don't fear because I'm with you. The Bible says, I'll never leave you and never forsake you. Now I like that the Bible says that we were walking through some valleys. Because if I'm walking through some valleys, it might not be easy. It might not be quick. But if I'm walking through some valleys, I got to come out. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. I don't know who that word is for today other than me and Butch. But if I'm walking through some valleys, I got to come out. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. We are in, the Bible says, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. I want to tell us today, we are in some shady times right now. We are in some shady times right now. But we got to keep walking. Watch this. People are dying in this dark times. It's real. But God has chosen us for a time such as this to walk through the valley of the shadow of death. These might be the end times that we're in. Well, if it is, then we are the generation that God has selected to walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Hallelujah. God knew about the wolf. He knew about the shadow when he called us. He knew where we would be in 2021. Veronica, April of 2021. God is sovereign. Nothing can catch him by surprise. He can't get no good news. God knew what we would be in for a time such as this. We've been called to walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Hallelujah. 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 I will fear no evil, for I got a good shepherd who is my defense. His rod and his staff comfort me. We need to make a declaration right now. And you can't look at nobody else. Because this here declaration got to be you, personal. I need us right now to just declare, I didn't say your wife. I didn't say your girlfriend. I didn't say your homie. I didn't say your dog. I said, I will fear no evil. We got to make a declaration today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. We got to get out of here. We got to get the baptism. Let's go down to Psalms 23:5. I'm giving us a lethal weapon as a believing sheep. Psalms 23:5 says, God, you prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. Watch this. You anoint my head with oil. I heard the Holy Ghost say, press down, shaking together, running over. God prepares a table for me in the presence of my enemies. Glory be to God. Jesus will prepare a table for me in the presence of my enemies. Jesus will fix me some food and say, sit down and eat. You see, since the enemy is bothering you, Jesus gonna bless you. Uh-oh. Watch this, watch this. The more the devil fights you, the more Jesus gonna bless you. I hear the Holy Ghost saying to somebody, sit down and eat. Sit down and eat. I want to just thank my enemies today. Because every time my enemies rise up against me, God says, uh-oh, it's dinner. Oh, you know, they don't hear me, Shayla. I said, every time they rise up against me, I start shouting, hallelujah, oh, glory to God. And I put my thing, and I said, I'm getting ready to sit down and eat. My God shall prepare a table in the presence of my enemies. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I will fear no evil. I fear no evil. That's why the Bible says, I don't know why I want to preach to Shayla today. Bet you won't miss church again. Oh, yeah, I'm a Church of God in Christ preacher. Don't mess around with the bishop. The Bible says that God will prepare a table in the presence of my enemies. And he says he will anoint the sheep with oil. Watch this. Jesus is the head of the church, and he has anointed the body of Christ with the Holy Ghost. Watch this, Nate. They anoint the sheep's head. The sheep have oil on their head because when the sheep go eat in the grass, oftentimes they stick their nose in the hole. Well, that's where the snakes live, in the holes. So they put the oil on the sheep's head so they have a snake repellent. I thank God because I stuck my nose in some places that should have killed me, but Jesus anointed me with the Holy Ghost. Whew. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. I said, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. I come this Sunday morning to serve notice to the devil. Devil, if you're going to fight me, you got to fight Jesus too. The Bible says, if God be for you, who can be against you? Hey, I want to let my enemies know this Sunday morning, if you gonna fight me, you gotta fight Jesus. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. If you gonna fight me, you gotta fight Jesus. You see, the good news about being Jesus' sheep is, if I'm Jesus' sheep, he is my good shepherd. If I'm Jesus' sheep, he is my good shepherd. Watch this. Watch this. I'm sick and tired of them talking about my Jesus is passive. My Jesus ain't passive. My Jesus can fight. Oh, I said my Jesus ain't passive. My Jesus can fight. Wait a minute. Devil, you can't win. Oh, my gosh. I said my Jesus can fight. He's not passive. Watch this. Watch this. The Bible says Jesus had a rod and a staff. Oftentimes it was one and the same. He had the rod and the staff so that when the wolf came to attack the sheep, Jesus would fight. My Jesus, a fight. My Jesus, a fight. Let me tell you something. When the devil comes in like a flood, my Jesus will raise up a standard against him. My Jesus, a fight. Hey, I don't have to argue with the devil no more. I don't have to defend myself with the devil no more. Because the Bible says, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. It says, be still and know that I'm God. He said, the name Jesus is a strong tower whereby the righteous run in and are saved. Hey, Jesus, my Jesus, watch this, my Jesus will fight. I remember times, Ron, when I put up my dukes and I said, that's it, that's all. And Jesus said, put your dukes down, this battle's not yours, it's the Lord. Oh, I remember times when I wanted to pay the devil back. I wanted to pay the hater back. And I got ready to pay him back. And Jesus said, stop it. Vengeance is mine, says the Lord. I got a Jesus that'll fight. I got a Jesus that'll fight. My Jesus will fight depression. My Jesus will fight abortion. My Jesus will fight division. My Jesus will fight racism. My Jesus will fight condemnation. My Jesus will fight sickness. My Jesus is a fighter. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. 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 The Bible says, oh my gosh, I feel the Holy Ghost Easter. The Bible says, touch not my anointed and do them prophets no harm. Oh, my Bible says, when they call on the name of Jesus. Whew, I remember when the old prayer warriors used to call on the name Jesus. I don't know if I got any old saints in here. When they used to call on the name Jesus. Watch this. The Bible says, whosoever call on the name Jesus shall be saved. He says, my Jesus is a strong tower whereby you run in and you're saved. Hey, I wish I had some prayer warriors that would call on the name of Jesus. I remember back in the old church when they would call on the name of Jesus. They didn't care how their hair looked. They didn't care about their makeup, ma'am. They didn't care about their clothes. They didn't care about the friend. They got to the altar and they said, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, wait. He said, Jesus, 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 Jesus. He said, Jesus, Jesus. They just start calling on the name Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. And Jesus would show up. Oh, my gosh. And Jesus would show up. Oh, my gosh. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can I just give you 2 more minutes? Watch this. I got to give him something good. I gotta give you this. Can I just preach 2 more minutes? Watch this. Watch this. So the Bible said that Jesus was leading them. Right? Right? Jesus was leading them. Come here, Robert. Come here, my bear. This Jesus. The Bible says that Jesus was leading them. The good news about Jesus leading is because Jesus said, I only came to be in the front to serve those behind me. Y'all think I like sweating up my suit, but I come to serve you. I promise to God I come to serve you. Because when I lay before Jesus, I want him to say, son, well done, my good and faithful son. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. So Jesus is leading. Look at that. The Bible says Jesus was leading. I got to finish this weapon. The Bible says that Jesus was leading. That means I'm behind him. Remy, Ron, come here for a minute, please. I like that they tall too, because watch this. Stand right here. You stand there. I want you to follow me, please, sir. The Bible says in Psalms 23:6, Chris. Somebody look like this. The Bible says in Psalms 23:6, the Bible says that goodness and mercy was following me. Oh, wait a minute. I'm talking about how I can walk and fear no evil. That ain't just some fancy stuff you want to say. I'm showing you how it's applicable right now. The Bible says Jesus is leading me. Oh, my gosh. Follow me. And the Bible says that goodness and mercy were following me. Oh, what happened? What happened? What happened? What happened? What happened? What happened? Hey, they got me boxed in. I said 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 they got me boxed in and the devil can't win. They got me boxed in and the devil can't win. Hey, I fear no evil, no evil, no evil. I fear no evil. I fear no evil. I fear no evil. I said about she talking about. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Woo! Come on up, ushers. Anybody know that you've been boxed in? Anna, I don't care what they're doing outside. Even if the enemy slip up and get in my home, it don't make a difference, Anna. Because when I'm standing in the kitchen, Jesus is in front of me, and goodness and mercy is behind me. And you can declare, get back, Satan. You can't get in because I'm boxed in and you can't win. I'm boxed in and Satan can't win. Hey! I'm excited about Jesus. I will fear no evil. Oh, my gosh. I didn't preach myself happy for it. Guys, this is a time that we call worship through giving. But let me show you what a blessing it is to give. I need a mic for Kaylee and Zach. Come on up. You can stand right there. I want you to hear this testimony from some real servers and givers.
Is it good? Mine. I don't know where to start.
Turn her up, Joe.
Start with our house. Start with my grandma's house. Okay, so we left our rental with our family of five to move in with my mom and my grandma because they needed our help. We were trying to sell my grandma's house so that we could get a suitable house for a family of seven. It's a lot of people in one house. I don't know if people know what the market is today, but it is not good. Trying to find a house for a family of seven when you don't have the best income, right? Like, who does? We found a house that we fell in love with. My grandma's house had not sold, but we put an offer on this house that we fell in love with.
You gotta hear this, Veronica.
They told us they would take our offer. It hadn't been in writing yet. They just told us that. That same day, they got a cash offer. Our offer is not cash. So they decided to go with that offer. Well, that same day, Pastor had told us it was our week. It was our week. He looked me in my face and told me, Kaylee, this is your week. This is your guys' week. Right before that, Pastor didn't know. My husband told me that house is ours. We didn't know that house, we didn't know what was happening with it. But he told me that house is ours. Pastor told me that's our week. We're like, okay, that house is ours. They were like, no, it's not. It's somebody else's house. Turns out somebody else in the church prophesied, and I didn't even tell you this, Pastor, but prophesied that on April 13th, something big was happening on April 13th. We waited. Turns out on April 13th, we got an offer on my grandma's house. So that a cash offer on my grandma's house. Okay, that's the first step into getting a new house. Then we find out those people backed out of our house that God told us was our house. They backed out of it. Now something even crazier, the people that backed out of it are the ones buying our house.
Come on, somebody.
Said, yo, you're in the wrong spot. Somebody. You're over here. They're over there. We got a house. We're in escrow.
Don't tell me what my God won't do. Don't look in my face and try to put my God in a box. Come on, somebody. I'm telling you the truth now. When you commit wholeheartedly, I'm not talking about being perfect, but I'm talking about you give your heart wholeheartedly in the kingdom. And you sow in the kingdom your prayers, your time, whatever you can, your finances, and you do what God says do, not what man. You do that, I guarantee you, God will bless your socks off. And people hear me say, bless your socks off, and they look funny because they think I'm talking about money. But I'm not. That's their shallow thinking. I'm talking about generational blessings. I'm talking about blessing relationships. I'm talking about blessing your grandkids' health. I'm talking about stopping the car accident. I'm talking about the man who had COVID right here. And when he was on the respirator, they start writing his last will and testament because he couldn't talk. He was in the hospital for 6 months, well, 3 months. He couldn't even talk. His wife started writing his last will and testament, asking me to pray and help prepare his funeral. I said, funeral? God ain't told me that. What's his number? They said, Pastor, he can't talk. I said, he can't talk? I said, can he hear? He said, yeah, he can hear. I called the nurse and I said, nurse, this is his pastor. Please put the phone to his ear. She put the phone to his ear. I begin to tell him, you shall live and not die in Jesus' name. Hey, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Hey, here he is. Here he is. And the nurse, wait a minute. And the nurse said the next day to his wife, and she texted me and said, now he's making sounds. He's talking. They said he wouldn't even be able to walk because his organs had been shut down too long. Here he is walking in my church, praising God. With a cane, praising God, driving on his own. Hey, don't tell me what my God won't do. When you do what God says do, when you say what God says say, when you go where God says go, he'll put his super on your natural. It's not me, it's not you, it's not us, it's Jesus. That's why I say to you this very day, this is a non-denominational, spirit-filled church. That's what I mean. The Holy Ghost makes moves in this place. Woo! Well, I got one more testimony, and I'm going to go home. I like it today. This woman told me, I don't know if y'all heard this last week, I'm going to tell you again. This woman, her and her husband, owned a home in Prescott Valley. Now, unbeknownst to me that this is his wife, I'm talking to him sometimes at Walmart. And I don't press nobody when it comes to Jesus. He knew I was a man of God. We talked about it. So, hey, when you get tired of fish sticks and you want some steak, come on to Mount Zion. No, I didn't tell him that. I didn't tell him that. But we were talking. And I never even knew his wife. And so he came up and we were praying, and I told him he was healed. He don't understand that the devil's going to try to make him think he's not, because he has an anointing on his life. So the devil's going to give him some bad news, whispering in his ear, but the devil is a lie. That man's healed. So anyway, in Jesus' name. So his wife came up to me one day, real talk, Veronica. And his wife said, I was at home for COVID all year. I didn't go to church. She said, and I slept in the guest room. She said, I can tell this story. She said, I slept in the guest room, not because I was mad at my husband, but because I needed real quality time with God, and I didn't want to lose my closeness because I wasn't at church. And she said, one day, somebody told her, you need to watch Mount Zion on TV. Not me. I'm nothing. She was watching Mount Zion on TV, and we called an altar call. And through the TV, she participated in an altar call and got the baptism of the Holy Ghost and began to speak in tongues in her home. Don't tell me what my God won't do. Come on, somebody. We serve a big God. In Jesus' name. She said to God saying to her, because she's asking God, make the devil take his hands off my husband. And God saying to her, I got it. So she's praising in the spirit. When somebody speaks in tongues, let me explain this, because every time something happens, I need to explain it. When somebody uses their heavenly prayer language, right? It's what you call a gift of the Spirit. And it's a gift. And let me be clear. If you don't receive that gift, you still go to heaven. So let's just be clear. But those people talking about if you don't speak in tongues, you're not going to heaven, that's a lie. That's, God said all I had to do was accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. But there are times that God will baptize you in the Holy Spirit and give you what we call extra power. And it shows up in two ways, right? All actuality, what she just did, if God didn't reveal to me what he was saying, that would have wasted our time. I'm just keeping it 100. Because your prayer language is your spirit talking to God about what you don't even know. It's praying for you, and you don't even know what it's saying. So really, if you have a heavenly prayer language, and you use it in front of me, it doesn't edify me. I don't know what you're saying. You don't even know what you're saying, but God does. But there also is a thing that God uses for the body of Christ called the gift of the Spirit, where God really wants to get something to us, a word, and he don't want us to mess it up, because you know how man is, Ron. They add their own stuff. And God said, bop, bop, bop. He didn't say all that. So when God really wants to get something to the body of Christ, he'll send a word to somebody in the spirit. That person may know what it was, or they may not. But if it was a real word from God for the body of Christ, then somebody there has to know. because there has to be an interpretation for it to be from God for us, or they wasted our time. Now, there can only be three of those in a service, or it's out of order. Also, when that manifestation comes, you'll know it's from God because it won't be rude. The Holy Spirit's not rude. You know, nobody can stand up in the middle of me preaching, talk about, Pastor, I got a word. Shut up, blah, blah, blah. I'm going to say, shut up and sit down. Because that's not God. Because God's not rude. He's a gentleman. He wouldn't interrupt his own message for another message. He's not the author of confusion. So I just took time to explain this, because every time the Spirit shows up, God forbid it shows up wrong, because I'm going to put you on blast. Because I don't play no games when it comes to the kingdom business. But when the Spirit shows up, I'll always explain it. Because we are a Spirit-filled church, but I promise you, sir, I won't let them get spooky. I'm from the old school. I'll sit you down. I promise you I will. And if they won't sit down, I'll have my ushers and deacons walk them out. Now, I got some big ones over there in the corner. They don't know they deacons yet. They can pick them up and carry them out. Ron said, amen. I didn't mean to keep you all that oh, past 1 o'clock, but we had to explain that. Amen. Come on, give me something, Frank. Y'all give me something. Let's go into worship. I need you to really ask God, what is it that he wants you to give? Look back at your offering. No, I'm serious. Look back at your offering and say, God, was this what you really wanted me to give? I'm telling you, if you really want to be blessed, God don't care what's in your hand. He just wants to know what's in your heart. Will you do what he says do? And a lot of times, God will tell you to do something crazy, because if it don't move you, it don't move God. Now, we don't beg at Mount Zion, but I want you blessed. Search your heart. Search your heart and see what God is telling you to do. That's all. Just see what God is saying right now. Go into worship. Let's worship our way out.
From you, I need.
It's time to give, Mount Zion. Let's worship our way out.
All I need is a touch from you. No one else can do the things you do. Take the wrong in my life and make it right. All I need is a touch from you. All I need is a touch from you. All I need. All I need is a touch from you.
Amanda, please.
No one else can do the thing. Take the wrong in my life.
Hallelujah.
And make it right. All I need.
Hallelujah.
Is a touch from
Hallelujah.
You. All I need.
Hallelujah.
Is a touch from you.
Hallelujah.
Touch me.
Hallelujah.
Touch me.
Hallelujah.
All I need is a touch.
Touch
me.
We'll find it.
Touch me.
You lost yourself. Get here. You lost yourself.
Touch me.
I need her delivered today.
All I need is a touch. Touch me. Touch me.
Hallelujah.
Touch me.
Come on, Nick.
All I need.
The Holy Ghost is in the altar today.
Touch
the Holy Ghost. Man,
wanna be made
old. Listen to me.
Touch me.
The church, I promise you, will buy you a new phone. You got my word on it. But right now,
all
I need that Spirit broken on me.
Okay.
Glory to God.
Touch
Come on.
Me.
Today, the altar is open.
Touch
There are some people in here today that are struggling. And I'm telling you now, the Holy Ghost is in this altar. God, watch this. God shows up in agreement. God takes pleasure in agreement. There's power in agreement. The Bible says if two or three gather in my name, the Bible says if two touch and agree, I'll glorify my son's name and do so. What you have here in the altar today is power for agreement. I'm telling you right now, God is in the altar. The Bible said if two or three gather in my name, there I'll be. I'm letting it all ride on Jesus in here. I put an earnest expectation on my God to move today. Hey, will there be one today? I'm telling you now, the Holy Ghost is moving in this altar. I don't know what your problem is. Somebody's struggling with arthritis. Somebody's doctor has lied to them again about cancer. Somebody's kid is still addicted. But I'm telling you today, somebody's kid is struggling with autism. And I'm telling you today that there's deliverance in the altar. Come now. Come now. Come now. Would y'all please stretch your hands towards these and press in. Let them be delivered now. In Jesus' name, please press your hands towards them.
Take the wrong in my life.
Hallelujah. 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 Come on. Come on, man. There is no condemnation in Christ Jesus. Do you hear me? There is no condemnation in Christ Jesus. I promise you, ma'am. I promise you.
Is a touch from you.
I promise you. I promise you there's no condemnation. Nobody's going to bother you.
Is a touch. Hallelujah. From you.
Nathan, help her pray for them. You too, Jack.
No.
Can we pray? Can we pray? We just want to pray. We're just going to stretch our hands out right here. We're just stretching our hands out. Nobody's going to bother you. 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 I promise you. I promise you. Let loose. Can I talk? Can I talk? I'm not going to touch you. Look at me. Look at me. I know. I know. Same thing's going on with her. I know. I know. Look at me. Stay with me. Stay with me. Stay with me. Y'all, I really need y'all's help on this. Stay with me. Stay with me. No, 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 no. Stay with me. No, nobody's going to touch you. Nobody's going to touch you. We love you. There's something bothering you and we want it out today. You hear me? We're going to call on him today. I know you're scared because you've been hiding it. But today I want you to let him out. We're going to cancel that attack today. You hear me? You hear me? You hear me? I'm calling on the Ancient of Days. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I command you, devil, take your hands off this woman now. Come out, devil. I said, come out now, devil. You come out right now, you foul and filthy spirit. Come out. Come out. Come out. What is his name? What's his name? What's the name? What is the name? What is the name? Ashley? Is Ashley killing you? I command you now, Ashley. I cover myself now in the blood of Jesus. So Ashley, you can't come in me. I am a child of the Most High God. I command you, Ashley. Do you hear me now, Ashley? I said, come out of her now. In Jesus' name. You take your hands off her, devil. Right now. Right now. I command you through the power of the Holy Ghost. Through the power of the Ancient of Days. Come out. Come out, devil. Come out. Now. Come out now, devil. Come out now, devil. Come out now.
Touch
yes.
Me.
No, you come out.
Come
you
on,
filthy
Jesus.
And foul spirit.
Touch
and you don't fear me. I will fear no evil. I said, touch come out now, devil. Me. In the name of Jesus. Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I command you to loose her. Loose her right now. Loose her right now. Loose her right now. In Jesus' name. I plead the blood of Jesus over your hands. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. The blood of Jesus. God, I'm asking you now to touch her from the top of her head to the bottom of her feet. Fill her with the Holy Spirit, God. Come out. You have no more power in her. What is your name? Ashley, stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Look at me, Ashley. Look at me. Look at me. Stay with me. I need you to accept Jesus today as your Lord and Savior. This devil is gone, but you've got to fill him with the strong man. The devil is gone. I've rebuked him. You're delivered, but you've got to fill yourself with the strong man. I need you to receive Jesus now. Say, Jesus. No, say, Jesus. No, say, Jesus. Say, Jesus, come into my life. Come on, stay with me. You come into my life, Jesus. Come into my life, Jesus. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me, Lord, for the sins I've committed. Lord, cover me with the blood of Jesus. Come on. Lord God, I accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior. I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart that Jesus is Lord. Say it. Fight. Jesus is Lord. Say it. Jesus is Lord. Say it. You got to fight. Jesus is Lord. Lord God, I'm asking that you fill her with the Holy Ghost now. Fill her from the top of her head to the bottom of her feet. Fill her now, Lord. Baptize her with fire and the Holy Ghost. Give God some glory in this place. All I need is a touch from you. All I need is a touch from you. Oh, give God glory in this place. All I need. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet. Hallelujah. I can't release this no matter how good it's been, Miss Hanson. Unless I give them an opportunity to know Jesus. Because I don't care how good you think you preach. And we do preach the paint off the walls in here, sir, sometimes. But it don't mean nothing if we don't give them an opportunity to know Jesus. Will there be one today that does not know Jesus? Now, I know it seems like I'm putting you on blast, but I am. I'm giving you a life that lasts. Will there be one in here that does not know Jesus? Come now. Come now. Come now. Come now. Come now. Pray us out, Nate. Amen. Glory be to God. Hey, don't forget, ladies, stop at the table and sign up for the Ladies of 80s. Those of you who want to see an anointed baptism, meet us downstairs in Jesus' name. God bless you. I'll see you next Sunday. Hallelujah.